for congestive heart failure. Let us start with the questions and their specific answers. The following are normally involved in pathogenesis of heart failures: a cardiac lesions that impair cardiac output, an increase in peripheral vascular resistance, and an increase in sodium water retention. These parameters play an important role in pathogenesis or pathophysiology of congestive heart failure. First one is impaired cardiac output. Second most important is peripheral resistance, and third one is sodium water retention. Next, the following are recommended at the initial stage of treating patient with heart failure: reduced salt intake, angiotensin converting enzyme inhibitors, and diuretics are preferred in initial stage of CHF. Next, digitalis increases the force of contraction of ventricles by increasing the rate of contraction but reducing the duration of systole. Next, digitalis slow the heart in congestive heart failure by increasing vagal tone, decreasing sympathetic overactivity, and direct depression of SA node, sinoatrial node. Next, the following are compensatory mechanisms that occur during the pathogenesis of congestive heart failure: an increase in ventricular end-diastolic volume, an increase in the concentration of plasma catecholamines, and increased activity of renin-angiotensin-aldosterone system. These are the compensatory mechanisms by body during congestive heart failure disease. Next, the non-glycoside positive inotropic drug is dobutamine. Next, aglycone is essential for cardiotonic action. Next, sugar molecule in the structure of cardiac glycoside influence pharmacokinetic properties. Next, choose the derivative of plant foxglove, digitalis, that is digoxin. Next, in very severe digitalis intoxication, the best choice is to use digoxin immune FAV. Next, this drug acts by inhibiting type 3 cyclic nucleotide phosphodiesterase, that is milrinone. Next, this drug is a selective beta 1 agonist, that is dobutamine. Next, the most important channel of elimination of digoxin is glomerulus filtration. Next, the following drug given concurrently can enhance toxicity of digoxin, that is quinidine. Enhance toxicity of digitalis. Next, digoxin is contraindicated in ventricular tachycardia, patient with ventricular tachycardia in which digitalis should not be administered. Next, the following drug can relieve symptoms of CHF but does not retard disease progression or prolong survival, that is digoxin. Next, tolerance to this inotropic drug develops after a few days, that is dobutamine. Next, select the drug that can help restore cardiac performance as well as prolong survival in CHF patients, that is metoprolol. Next, the preferred diuretic for mobilizing edema fluid in CHF is furosemide. Next, select the drug which is an inodilator beneficial in refractory congestive heart failure, that is amarinone. Next, the dose of digoxin in congestive heart failure is adjusted by monitoring the heart rate and symptoms of congestive heart failure. Next, all of the following statements regarding cardioglycoside are true. They inhibit sodium-potassium ATPase and thereby increase intracellular calcium in myocardial cells. Children tolerate higher dose of digitalis than adults. The most frequent cause of digitalis intoxication is concurrent administration of diuretics that deplete potassium. Hypokalemia is the major problem with digitalis toxicity and use of diuretics. Next, in a failing heart, therapeutic dose of digoxin has no effect on the following parameter, tone of ventricular fibers. Next, long-term maintenance therapy with digoxin is the best option in the following category of CHF patients, that is patient with associated atrial fibrillation. Next, digitalis is most suitable for treatment of CHF when it is due to long-standing uncontrolled hypertension. Next, the following action of digoxin is responsible for beneficial effect in auricular fibrillation, that is depression of AV conduction. Next, which drug can afford both hemodynamic improvement as well as disease-modifying benefits in CHF, that is losartan. Next, the statement regarding cardiac glycosides are true. They inhibit the activity of sodium-potassium ATPase, they increase vagal tone, they have a very low therapeutic index. Next, milrinone is a best used as an additional drug along with conventional therapy to tide over crisis in refractory CHF. The following drug is used for short-term control of emergency heart failure but not for long-term treatment of congestive heart failure, that is dobutamine. Next, beneficial effects of diuretic in CHF patient include the following: symptomatic relief. Next, glyceryl trinitrate is used in CHF for rapid symptom relief in acute left ventricular failure. Next, digoxin produces the following effects in arterial flutter. Next, reduces ventricular rate, prevent shift of AV block to lower grade and converts arterial flutter to arterial fibrillation. Next, digoxin afford the following benefits in CHF. Next, restore the cardiac compensation and relieve symptom. Digoxin relieve cardiac compensation and relieve symptoms. Thereby, it is helpful. Next, select the most suitable antiarrhythmic drug for counteracting ventricular extrasystole due to digoxin toxicity, that is lignocaine. Next, all of the following drugs are used in the treatment of severe congestive heart failure, that is digoxin, dobutamine and dopamine. Next, all of the following statements regarding cardiac glycosides are true. Digoxin is a mild inotrope, digoxin increases vagal tone, and digoxin acts by inhibiting the sodium potassium ATPase activity. Next, the most cardiac manifestation of cardiac glycoside intoxication is means digoxin poisoning. Artery ventricular junctional rhythm, second degree arterioventricular blockade and ventricular tachycardia are the major manifestations of digitalis toxicity or cardiac glycoside intoxication. Next, this drug inhibits breakdown of CAMP in vascular smooth muscle, that is amrinone. Next, the positive inotropic action of digoxin takes several hours to develop because binding of digoxin to sodium potassium ATPase is slow. After sodium ATPase inhibition by desorption, calcium loading of myocardial fibers occur progressively with each contraction. Next, all of the following statement regarding inhibition of or inhibitor of type 3 phosphodiesterase are true. They raise CAMP concentration in cardiac myocyte, they reduce afterload, and they are associated with a significant risk for cardiac arrhythmia. Next, potassium therapy tends to counteract the cardiac toxicity of digitalis by reducing the affinity of sarcolemmal sodium potassium ATPase for digitalis, suppressing ectopic automaticity enhanced by digitalis. Next, among all cardiac glycosides, digoxin is the most commonly used because it has intermediate plasma half-life, so that dose adjustment are possible every 2 to 3 days and toxicity abates rather rapidly after discontinuation. Next, drugs most commonly used in chronic heart failure are cardiac glycoside, diuretics, and angiotensin converting enzyme inhibitors. Next, all of the following statement concerning the use of angiotensin converting enzyme inhibitors in the treatment of heart failure are true. They improve hemodynamics by decreasing afterload. They may slow the progression of heart failure by preventing myocardial and vascular remodeling. They are effective first-line agent in the treatment of chronic heart failure. These all statements are true for angiotensin converting enzyme inhibitors. Next, all of the following statements concerning angiotensin converting enzyme inhibitors are true. Enalapril is a prodrug that is converted to an active metabolite, that is enalprilate. They reduce secretion of aldosterone. They can produce hyperkalemia in combination with a potassium sparing diuretics. Next, infusion of potassium chloride is indicated in digitalis toxicity when the manifestations are pulses begeminus with heart rate 100 per minute in a patient on maintenance digoxin therapy. In this condition, infusion of potassium chloride supplementation is recommended. Thanks for watching this video. Thank you.